Thousands of workers may have been out on the streets to protest the minimum wage today under the South African Federation of Trade Unions, but other union federations elected not to join the countrywide marches.
COSATU and FEDUSA have come out to say that the minimum wage of 3,500 rand was negotiated in good faith over a period of 2 years and was signed off by government, labour and business.
The broad force of labour remains unable to speak with one voice. SAFDU spearheaded the nationwide march today while others decided to stay put. COSATU says the minimum wage was part of a bigger discussion to ultimately create a comprehensive social security net for families who didn't earn enough. And it says that discussion with government is ongoing. However, General Secretary Bekkie Njalin-Njali says it's important that when workers are pressed to go on strikes, that indeed it's their choice to do so.
It can't come from the top, from the leadership, that we instruct union members and say, on this day you are not going to go to work, you must lose your salary, and therefore you must be taking this course. It has to come from the members themselves. They need to say to the leadership, we want to go on strike because we want to air our views on this particular issue.
Another federation questioned the motives of the latest labour action, also arguing that the minimum wage deal had been done and dusted already.
I think if a person looks at what is the intention and the purpose of the strike, then it's almost like we can say that the train already left the station, because the national minimum wage have been negotiated through government, business and labour in NATLAC for the last 2 years. And during that period, you know, the president pushed labor and business very, very hard because we wanted to make sure that we're going to put in a minimum wages that's going to make a meaningful impact in the lives of our people. And when we look at the numbers, you would see about 4.6 million people earn less than the minimum wages of 3,500 per month. And that was the big motivation for us to even push government, you know, and business harder. But unfortunately, we pushed against a situation of costs. And the minimum wages will also be a cost for companies, and that is a reality that we have to face.
COSATU's General Secretary poured cold water over the notion that the latest labour law amendments would do away with workers' rights to strike and the protection thereof.
There's nothing new about the right to strike. Nobody can change the right to strike. So people say it is not going to be difficult for workers to go on strike. Absolutely opportunistic and disingenuous, misinforming people in terms of this. What is in the amendment is the question of whether the ballot is the paper that you are given to decide on a strike, should it be secret or not? And what is in the amendment now is that it has to be a secret ballot. But more importantly, the Act says whether you go ballot or not, that's what is important. Whether you ballot or not, your strike will be protected.
If there had been a collective change of mind among labour, perhaps today's proceedings would have made a dent in how the minimum wage is set to unfold. But with COSATU and FEDUSA seemingly willing to support the current minimum wage as is, it begs the question whether today's action will make a difference. Nompumelelo Seziba, SABC News, Johannesburg.